Hello everyone. In this video, I'm revisiting a project I started a couple months ago. It's a custom pre-runner style build using a FIU FY01 Fighter 1 short course truck chassis and an old 72 Chevy pickup body. As always, I'll be sure to include a link to part 1 of this build below in the description. In that video, I do an overview of the Fighter 1 and discuss some ideas of how I want to build this truck. Although I haven't made a huge amount of progress on this vehicle since the last video, I've received a number of requests for an update on this build, so I thought I'd make a quick video showing the progress I've made so far, as well as discuss some future plans. The first thing I wanted to do was remove the rear battery holder. I figured I could fit the battery somewhere on the front of the chassis, so this part isn't necessary. By removing the battery holder, I'll have much more room for a cage. Removing this piece was very simple, it's just held on with 4 screws. Two additional screws need to be removed temporarily from one of the shock supports before the bottom section can be removed. I also wanted to remove this body mount bracket from the front. I don't plan on using this piece, instead I'll be building my own body mount and battery holder. I designed and printed this cage. I made it so that the back half would sit up on top of the rear shock supports for additional stability. I also printed out this piece to use as the back side of the cab, doing my best to ensure the part would fit snug. After seeing how the body will line up on the chassis, I cut out the rear window on the cab and used a sanding drum to remove material around the opening so that the backside cab piece will fit correctly. I gradually removed more material, making sure to check how the back end fits periodically. After some time, the back piece fit up against the body how I wanted it to. To secure the back section to the rest of the body, I used a generous amount of shoe goo, which did a great job of solidly attaching the piece in place. I made sure to wipe off any excess glue before it dried. With the back side of the cab solidly attached, I marked where I wanted to drill the holes for the cage. I started by drilling some smaller pilot holes and then gradually worked them bigger until they were the size I needed them. With the holes drilled, I removed the tape and applied some more shoe goo for additional strength. Once the glue dried, I began to sand the transition between the polycarbonate body and the printed piece. I won't be able to duplicate the exact B-pillar curvature of the full-scale cab, but I should be able to create a nice-looking transition between the two pieces. After several minutes of sanding, the transition was starting to feel smooth. I then moved to using sandpaper and a fine file to further smooth the transition. After that, I used Milliput epoxy putty to fill the gap and smooth some of the visible 3D printed layers. As you can see, the surface of the 3D printed cage looked pretty rough, detracting from its scale appearance. To smooth the surface, I used a sanding drum at a low speed to quickly sand away any large imperfections, particularly the sections where the support structure was when the part was being printed. I used a small grinding stone bit to get into hard-to-reach corners. Once finished with the rotary tool, I used a file in certain spots. I also printed this roof rack, which will need some finishing work as well. However, this part was printed using a shorter layer height, so it didn't require as much sanding. With everything sanded, I was ready to apply XTC 3D to the part's surface. Normally, I would use sandpaper to sand the entire surface of the part and use some filler to help smooth imperfections before applying XTC 3D. However, I decided to save some time and skip these steps. XTC 3D is a resin coating that creates a smooth surface when applied to a 3D printed part. Once dried, the coating can easily be sanded and painted. I applied two thick coats to the roll cage and one coat to the roof rack. After the coating dried, I sanded any large imperfections. Here's how the cage looks right now. It's not pretty, but it's much smoother than it was before. I'll need to do some more sanding before determining what the next step for this part is. Either a little bit of filling with putty and some more sanding, or another light coat of XTC 3D. The cab also needs some more work in the transition between the two pieces, but it's very close to being how I want it. In fact, I'm very pleased with how well the transition looks. I'm confident after a little more work and a few coats of primer, it will be hard to tell that this body was built from two separate pieces. Aside from finishing the cab and the body, the next steps for this build are mounting the body and the cage to the chassis, making a battery mount, and working on the fender and bedside pieces. As always, I'll be sure to keep you guys up to date on this project and all the other builds I'm working on as well. If you'd like more frequent updates, be sure to follow me at the social media links below. I'm making it a point to upload at least one picture every day or two, plus I've got some sneak peeks at some builds that I haven't yet shown here. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave it in the comment section below, and I will do my best to answer it. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a great day.